And I want to have more of it, and I want to have better sex, and I want to be able to not only have it all, but also be it all, you know, and be a wife and mom, be a ravenous sex goddess, be everything that you want to be.
Hi, Stacey.
Hi, Jana.
Nice to meet you. Thank you so much for your time. And whoa, what I really like this series.
So, great.
Yes. I would like to know, like, you have the inspiration of the book, 44 chapters about four men. But what was about that book, like that timeline, like the story that got your attention and created this series?
Yeah. So I connected very personally with the idea of a wife and mom who can't help but think about those wild child single in the city days and who misses that former version of herself, you know? And so what was exciting for me was a chance to create this series that's a sparkly fever dream version of the past and then the best sex you ever had and the impossibly sexy men you had it with, but that is also rooted in this really honest exploration of what happens to us as we grow up and become allegedly responsible grown-ups and all of the choices that we're forced to make along the way, you know, and ultimately it's asking that age-old question, you know, can you have it all?
I don't know. I also relate to this story. I don't think you can have it all at the same time. So I think it goes in waves. Even if you have like just one relationship, I don't know. That's just my opinion.
No, but right. that is, you know, you can have it all, but not all at the same time is sort of the mantra in feminist thinking right now, you know, and I've always bristled at that because I do feel like it's another way of saying you can't have it all. And I think that that's what's so frustrating for many women and particularly for wives and mothers, you know, you're not supposed to be a mom and a ravenous sex goddess at the same time, you know? And yet I think that, you know, a lot of women who find themselves in that situation, they really miss that part of themselves and they want to express all parts of themselves. And so hopefully this series is the way for them to get to do that.
Yeah, I like it because you are able to balance like her past life with her present life and also bring like the living outside the city. I like that balance. Was it difficult for you to put that balance on the story?
I mean, that was so much a part of it for me. You know, the show is set in the Connecticut suburb where I grew up, and it was very much about the train in and out of the city and that life, you know, when you're living in the city and then when you get married and have kids and live outside of the city. I mean, it was that dichotomy that was really exciting to me to sort of visually represent this identity crisis that she's going through.
The other thing that I think it's beautiful, like were the sex scenes, how was like working with the Cassie's, the choreographer for
yes.
the scenes? How was like the approach for those
yeah,
scenes?
So it was incredible to work with Casey. You know, we had written the scenes out very specifically on the page, you know, and because it was very important to understand what Billy was missing, to feel on a visceral level why this time in her life, this version of herself, this man, why they're looming so large in her eyes, you know, and in her mind. And so we wrote a lot on the page and you know, it's one thing to write it on the page. It's another thing when you come to set and you're like, oh my gosh, we're actually going to be shooting this. And Casey was so great and took it to a whole other level. I mean, we obviously rehearsed a lot. We had all female directors. You know, it was a really safe space for everyone to explore. But, you know, Casey would talk to us about what the breath was even in each scene, you know, to really get to the deep level, emotional level of what was happening in each moment.
Yeah. And what do you want people to learn, especially us women, married women, to learn
yeah.
from this series?
Well, I hope that, you know, women feel seen and that they feel free to not only escape their lives and remember their own incredible nights on the town or to fantasize about what those incredible nights on the town would be, but to really feel free to say, yes, I've had sex and I want to have more of it. And I want to have better sex. And I want to be able to not only have it all, but also be it all, you know, and be a wife and mom, be a ravenous sex goddess, be everything that you want to be.
Amazing. That's awesome. Thank you so much, Stacey. And I hope everybody liked this series. See you
Thank
soon.
You so much.
Bye-bye. Bye. If you like this video, don't forget to comment, to like, and subscribe to our channel right here.